What's up guys, welcome to a new guide, and in this guide we will talk about Kagura. Kagura is one of the strongest mages in the game. She has high mobility, high burst, high sustain. She has everything to escape and to do damage to the enemy team. And with this rework she has become even stronger. So guys, in this guide you will learn how to play Kagura perfectly, and I will help you guys teach you with Unique, a 95% win rate Kagura with over 2,500 games. So let's start with the guide. So for the pre-match, the emblem set you want to use is the Magic Emblem set. For the build, the first item you want to build is the jungle item. The battle spell you want to use is Retribution, because you will use it for clearing the jungle and get a lot of XP on the opponent. The build will be this following. It gives high burst, high poke and high sustain with the spell vamp. It has a lack of cooldown reduction. You can replace the fourth item with the cooldown reduction at Enchanted Talisman, which gives you also mana regeneration and 20% cooldown reduction. It's what you prefer. If you have a poking composition, you want to have the cooldown reduction to poke the enemies, but this is the most standard build to do a lot of burst but also have a lot of sustain. So this is my recommended build according to Unique. So this is the passive. When you go to your umbrella, you will stun and get a shield. The first ability will use your umbrella to the enemy. It slows down enemies. You can replace your umbrella once it's placed somewhere. Second ability makes you teleport to your umbrella. It also can use, when it's blue, you can use to dodge skill shots or clear or purify the enemy stuns. As you can see here, Cyclops is ulting me, but I use my blue dash and it removes the snare. The ultimate will do a lot of damage. It resets the first ability and it pulls enemies towards the umbrella. When you use it, when it's in blue, it will push back the enemies. So as you can see here, Unique uses the umbrella to do a lot of damage and uses a second ability, ultimate, to do a lot of damage. So you can see here the full combo, it pulls down the Rafaela and I go back in with my second ultimate and you can see a lot of damage. So for the skill order, the first ability you want to max is the first, then you want to do your ultimate whenever possible. So combo training. In this gameplay I will show you guys Unique gameplay. As I told you, he has 2,500 games on Kagura with 95% win rate in Europe. And he's destroying everyone with his Kagura skills. He's glorious legend, and last season he is playing a lot every day, and he will be the new rank mythical legend or whatever it is. He will be it soon enough. So as you guys see, he is like the best Kagura I've ever seen in my life. And you'll see. So Kagura, what Unique always does, he always has like a sort of same strategy. So what he's doing, he's clearing the wave as fast as possible and then he will invade the blue buff. So he's just poking and trying to clear the wave as fast as possible. So now he will invade. His team probably knows it because they play a lot of Unique. So he actually steals the blue buff here and what they want to do. So Freya actually gets clumped up here and he uses a dash over the wall to chase the Freya even more. Slows down with the first ability and now Freya will die. First blood for the enemy, or for the Irithyll. So Unique always plays aggressive, so he is trying to do something under tower here. So he will he's poking the Tigre down, out attacking even more, taking one tower shot, but he got a shield and now it's only Mia on the tower. But they will go away because Mia, they will not get it. So he's level 3 already and it's pretty fast. He's almost level 4. And he will do the jungle camp now. As you can see, he used Retribution first, then the umbrella. But you can see, like, the Retribution, even he used Retribution because you will farm so much faster. You can invade, you can steal the buffs, which gives a lot of control. And he nicely calculates his damage and he perfectly kills the Maya with like last out attack to finish it off. So he will go and steal the enemy jungle now. So the enemy team has less XP and he will be a lot of XP. He will be so ahead in XP, as you can see. So as you can see, he's level 4, almost level 5. Cyclops is still level 3 in the top lane and he does a lot of bursts. Aurora follows. Fanny makes a nice income and nuke their damage together. It's insane. So yeah, he's level 5. He's destroying, roaming a lot, like, guys. What I want to say, Kakura, play her in the mid lane, guys. She is the best in the mid lane. You can clear the way very fast. You will win against every opponent 1v1. In lane, you have a lot of poke, you have shields, you have a lot. So just be sure, guys, play her Kakura in the mid lane. You, like, I know a lot of people play Marksman in the mid lane, but Kakura will stomp every one of you. So just play Kakura in the mid lane. So you can roam around the map, gank the other lanes with your poke, with your engage. So that's what you basically want to do. So he's just basically out attacking the tower a bit. He's checking the enemy blue with, and he knows he's up, so he's doing it. Mia's incoming in the mid lane, as you can see on the mini map. He will stay close to the wall. Like, you can see Kakura staying close to the wall. So if she has to run, she will dash over the wall and she's out. But there's no one coming for help or getting the blue buff, so she just takes it. Now she's roaming around the map. Like, Kakura, it's watching map always, so Tegra was low HP, but he managed to get out. But he's not wasting time, he's invading, he's taking the enemy jungle so much, he's like creating so much opportunities. So he's level 7 already, and you have to check later what level they are. Like, he's getting a lot of XP lead just because he's invading, taking on mid jungle and not wasting any single bit of time. So he's just clearing, like, with his first ability. Wave clear is pretty good with Kakura. So he sees this Freya. Freya is going on him, he dashes out. He slows the Freya with his first ability, but also hitting the turtle. Minotaur used the ultimate of Freya, and he gets the kill on Freya with the umbrella. And they also get the turtle meanwhile. So level 7, almost level 8. Enemy Maya still level 5. Kakura just wave clearing because he doesn't want to waste any time. He wants to invade or whatever he wants to do. So he's just just using his umbrella to clear a wave. And now he will use umbrella to poke. So he gets to use the ultimate on the Maya, and he gets grabbed, and he almost gets one shot, this Maya. And he missed the umbrella on the Maya. It would have been a kill, but he missed it. So he even tried again to hit him. But now his Freya is here. Kakura wants to get out, so he's still slowing down the Tegra. Tegra cannot escape, like, the slows are too good, and he did, yeah, it's like, as well, the positioning of this Kakura is really good. You can see Freya's on him, no chance, he gets stunned. Now he goes in back again, very aggressive, dodges the Lapu Lapu ult, dodges the other thing, and now they get, it will get a triple kill. So now they will take down the turret. Kakura umbrella is zoning the enemy. What you also want to do, at least, is like the umbrella, put it to the enemy, close to the enemy, so you can, like, the time before it hits the enemy is shorter. Like, if you have the umbrella on you, and you want to use the you want to poke someone, it has to travel a lot of distance before you can hit the enemy. But if the umbrella is already there, you only have to move like 2 pixels to hit someone. So there's no dodging time. So always be sure when you're poking enemy, make sure the umbrella is close to them already. So Kakura is saying retreat, because there are two in the top lane. Fanny is not here. Mantar is basically alone, but he's still going in. Use the ultimate, and let ultimate finish. Use the second ultimate and gets the triple kill, and also gets a poke on Lapu Lapu. So that was like a 3v4, and they get 3 kills out of it. So Lapu Lapu is also low HP, but Lapu Lapu knows he has to heal, so they can do some free damage on the tower. I don't know if they can get it, but we'll see. Oh, sorry, Atayon here. So he gets stunned on the tower, was not that good. So he uses ultimate godlike for Fanny. And he's staying in the back since he's low HP, slowing down the enemies. They know they cannot reach Yunik. So I think he will go back soon enough. He doesn't have spell yet. Oh, he gets stunned by the Freya, and he gets out alive. And he goes back in again, go dash out, gets the monster kill. This guy is not scared, he knows exactly what he is doing. As you can see in the bottom lane, Maya is split pushing, so I think he will go there. Let's see, yeah, he will go there. He has to defend it. So guys, I just have to say, this Kakura, this Yunik is definitely the best player in Kakura. So, okay, nice, Fanny going in for the kill. He will try to get the blue buff, probably. Yeah, he will, or Fanny will take it, maybe. Yeah, Fanny takes it. Fanny needs a blue buff more than Kakura, and Kakura already has the blue buff. So, he will just look on the map. So, what I just want to see, meanwhile, Be sure, guys, be sure to invade a lot. Play aggressive with Kagura if you know how to play her. Kagura is very hard to play, so don't make any mistakes because it's hard. It will be hard. Like, after watching this guide, you cannot play Kagura yet. You have to practice a lot. You have to get a feeling of the skills, how they function, and just practice, guys. It's all about practicing. So Aurora gets a nice ultimate off. Kagura is poking with her ultimate, goes in, Yuta gets a godlike, and now he will dash out over the wall and keeps poking again. That's what you can really do. Like, you can go in on the tower and dash out eventually, because this dash is a purify. Like, every stun gets cancelled when you use your second dash. So he's just poking again. Meanwhile, they are taking the tower. The Kagura umbrella is such high damage, guys. Like, poke is insane, don't underestimate it. So he's poking, he gets hit by the Cyclops ultimate, but uses the dash to get out of it. And he's playing really, like, look at his position, he's playing really aggressive. Just keeps poking them, keep poking. Until they're low HP, and then he will go finish them off with the burst. So he's using ultimate, gets a kill on the Cyclops, goes in for the Tegreal, but there's no point. So Tegreal, he gets stunned by the Tegreal, which is bad, get knocked back on the tower. He's not taking tower damage, now he's taking tower damage. But he's healing pretty much a lot. And look at this burst on the Maya. She gets one shot, and Kagura gets the triple kill. I think that is GG. 10-0-10, guys, and I want to see the end game damage, guys. If you play Kagura aggressive as this, you have a lot of damage in late game. You carry, you make the enemies so they have to suffer because of this. So let's take a look. Okay, he's Glorious Legend, 538 stars. This was, the end of last season. I think he recorded it yesterday. 29 wins in a row in a ranked game. That's how good he is, guys. So 10-0-10. So let's take a look at his damage. I think it's huge. 45% of the team damage. That's what I mean. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the guide. I hope you enjoyed how to play Kagura. I had to use Unix gameplay, so you actually have to understand how it works, how to do the tactics. And I think it's the best to learn through his gameplay. Like the basics for before the gameplay, what the build is, how the abilities work. But after seeing this gameplay, just try to use his tactic, invade, and you just use his tactic. I think that's a good beginning to start, and be sure to practice with the abilities. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the guide. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned from it, and hope you will practice Kagura, because she's such an amazing mage. Anyway, thank you for watching, guys, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.
What's up, guys? I'm doing a skin giveaway every video. What you have to do to enter is like the video, subscribe to my channel, and as third, send your ID in the comments. The winner will be announced random during the video.